Fellowship Hall, and they begin at 5:30. This weekend, the 26th annual Old Fashioned Planners Day will be held in Garland. Also, on Saturday at 5:30, the Politician Appreciation Day will be held at Lou Mill Vineyard. There's a special meeting regarding the budget next Tuesday, the 27th at 4 p.m. And offices will be closed on Friday, the 30th, in observance of the Easter holiday, Good Friday. Moving over to April, on Tuesday, the board meets at 6:30 that evening. Also, the diabetes forums continue through April on Wednesdays. On Saturday, the 7th, from 11 until 5, the Blainboro Spring Fling will be held. The Health and Human Services Advisory Committee meets on Monday, the 9th, at 5:30 p.m. There is a Dementia Friendly, the second series will be on Tuesday, April 10th, from 9 until 11. And that will be titled Effective Communication Strategies. The chamber meets that day at 12, and then the opioid forum will be held at Blaine Community College at 2. That may be at 1. Is that?
It's going to be 1, and 4, and it's going to be at the health department.
I just thought about that. It is in the health department?
Yeah, the book department.
Which one is it now?
The 4.
That's one, 1 and 4?
At the health department.
1 and 4.
There's some kind of special, I can't remember the title.
We've got people coming in.
Yeah, there's going to be special people.
I'm getting information that comes out.
At the where?
Health department, 1 and 4.
On Thursday, the 12th, from 10 until 12, there is a session titled Opioid 101 that will be hosted by East Point, and it will be held at the Powell Melvin Agricultural Center. That evening, from 5:30 until 8 p.m., the North Carolina Association of County Commissioners District Meeting will be held in Whiteville. And also that evening at 7, the Bladen County Fire Association meeting will be held at the Inland Fire Department. The board meets on Monday, the 16th, at 6:30 p.m. On Wednesday, the 18th, at 7 p.m., there's a Parks and Recreation Master Plan Community Meeting, and that will be held at the library. Also, on Thursday, the 19th, from 12:30 until 3:30, the Division on Aging will have its Spring Fling at Lou Mill Vineyard. And then on Saturday, the 28th, at 10 a.m., the Kelly Spring Festival will be held at the Kelly Ballpark.
Greg, on April the 7th, also, they're having that fundraiser for Robbie, Russell's son.
Okay, yeah, thank you.
And then the 21st of April, they're having one for Alvin Butler family in Center Road.
21st, okay, thank you. At Center Road, Baptist Church.
Do they have time for Robbie? Do they have time going for Robbie and,
It's in the evening, I think, at the first meeting.
Yeah.
Sure. We'll add it to the calendar. On the 7th.
Item B.
Okay, thank you. Ms. Renee Davis was unable to be here this evening, and there is a bid that has been offered to the county to purchase county-owned property, and the expense to the county is $5,700. The bid amount that has been offered is also $5,700. And this is property that is located at 157 Tommy's Drive. In the Elizabethtown Township.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Got a motion by Mr. Peterson, a second by Mr. Cogdell. Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
Yes, sir. Also, moving to item C. Last week we mentioned the Opportunity Zone program that is a result of the tax reform that was approved this past December by Congress. And in North Carolina, each county, there will be approximately 250 zones chosen, or that actually census tracts. And each county has the opportunity to offer one or to recommend one. And then Governor Cooper will choose 150 additional tracts. We have had conversation, and as we mentioned last week, the census tract that is recommended is the one that extends from Dublin through the Highway 87 corridor to the county line near Comores. And then the alternate that is recommended is the tract that includes Elizabethtown. And this offers tax incentives, or will provide tax incentives for new investment. Yes, sir.
On that, when that track was proposed, who proposed that and how did that come to be?
Well, it's through Congress.
Who did that?
Well, I know I've had a conversation with Mr. Chuck Houston, speaking on the development director. He was in a meeting a week or so ago with a gentleman from DuPont, I mean, not DuPont, Smithfield, and he asked about this. I had a conversation with Mr. Eddie Madden, and he also, we discussed this as well, and he seemed to think that that made, you know, was a logical approach. So I don't know that there's any right or wrong answer. We don't know exactly where the most investment will come from, so.
The only reason I was asking, I was looking at the cores that get set up, and I was hoping that the commission would have a closer look at what was wrong with that. If they were gonna do something like this, that you would be involved and know precisely the reason why and how this thing was put in place. You know, this is gonna be one of a lifetime opportunity for them to put these cores in. I wanna make sure all pieces of it is inclusive with everybody.
Well, we want, yes, sir. Well, that's why we sent the information to you a few weeks ago, as quickly as we were informed about it. Had it on the agenda last week to try to get feedback. So I don't know that there's any right or wrong, so we're open to any suggestions from the board.
I'm gonna ask if Mr. Houston to come in and do a presentation to us to give justification for what he's done and where he's going.
I didn't understand. I don't understand the handout. I couldn't understand.
I don't know that, unfortunately, I don't know that a lot of, we've tried to get additional information from Mr. Richardson and others, and I don't know that, I'm sure some are, you know, maybe could explain it, but there are a lot of folks, it's so new, there are a lot of folks that can't tell you the exact specific.
But I understand we had to put the cores in place as a timeline, that you had to get things to put in place with those zones, but I'm trying to say, I would like to know how they were designed and why.
Okay, that maybe, that's a very good question. Maybe I didn't communicate clearly enough. These are census tracts, and in Bladen County, there are six, there are only six census tracts in Bladen County. And Robin, if you could pull that, if you could scan it or zoom out.
When do you have to have a response to this?
Sometime.
I would like to have a little workshop or something about that time, this would be closer.
Okay, zoom in a little bit more if you can, Robin. These census tracts are already established, and so when I say a zone, I'm just referring to a census tract. So it's not like anything's been formed or whatever. I mean, we're just selecting one of the six.
It's kind of hard for us to define the terminology and what's going into this.
Right.
We look at the census tracts and want to identify them more precisely where they fall in that economic barrier. If you're talking about bringing economics to that region of the county, that's what you're talking about doing, getting investment.
My request is to get Chuck scheduled to come in on the meeting.
That's what we're talking about.
When is the deadline?
David Richardson had hoped to have the information this week, but if I understood correctly, the governors will make the choice in April, so I'm not sure that.
What I'm saying is, I don't have a problem with them taking that professionalism expertise to go ahead and try to outline this to get it in.
Right.
But I like to know how, what goes into it, what everything's been into making that determination with the zoning. Like I'm saying, Blade Bird's out.
And the simple, I mean, I'll be glad to tell you the simple answer on that. The simple answer is that the most investment, the largest investments in Bladen County in recent years have come from reinvestment in the facilities at Smithfield and DuPont or Chemours.
But for going forward, that's not helping what they've invested in the past.
Right.
No, I know, but they continue to reinvest.
Sorry, they're not going to invest a whole lot more.
When I was in D.C., the reason that they were doing it and everybody was so excited about it, that they knew they had companies that was already there that was reinvesting. Some of them are already doing that. The thing was to bring in new ideas and concepts and new people that would
right,
have
oh,
that
certainly.
Incentive to come in and invest in the rural county, not Smithfield or other industry would come in. The technology and different types of vision would come in and say, with that kind of capital gains tax eliminated, would they come in and invest? Not just in Smithfield.
Right.
Smithfield is going to add little hog houses and little ice plants. We need to look at different types of energy coming into town. That would be my concern.
I would say, due to the time frame on our little group meeting, we're trying to set the time on, see if we can include him on small group meetings, and that way we can tie it in and expedite and get it covered.
I'll be back there.
And Mike could do it Tuesday before budget meeting.
Can do so.
And Mr. Chairman, the only other thing I wanted to mention is that we did place at your desk there a phase four project schedule, so that's for your information.
Thank you, Mr. Martin.
Thank you.
Individual delegation wishes to address commissioners. Any correspondence? Can I get a motion that we adjourn?
Approve.
Have a motion by Mr. Cogdell, second by Mr. Gooden. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Go